I said 2013 was my year and I heard God laugh. Asking to be great is like ordering pain and humiliation in a tall opaque glass. It goes down smooth but thrashes through the body. You become delusional, calling the enterprise, saying, "Yo, beam me down, Scotty." Ready to give up, but that's never been an option. Come on, man, stop complaining. Anyone who's anything has drank the same concoction. Some have tasted worse. God knows what he's doing. He puts you on this earth and enables you to keep pursuing. So I'll be tough and say 2013 is my year to shine. God never comes when you want him to, but he's always right on time.
Saturday, April 13th, 7 o'clock in the morning, and I just woke up. Yeah, my face is ashy. I just woke up. I don't have on a shirt. Might not have on any bottoms, but I just woke up. And I don't want to hear anything. Just sit back. Just listen. Let it come natural. First, I want to give a shout out to all the barbers who's managed to take my hairline back. I just noticed that I got a baby LeBron James starting off. I don't like that, people. I'm traumatized behind that. I don't want to go to work with a damn oversized headband on. I don't want to do that. And I don't want to go bald yet. I'm still too fat in the face. I got you. I'm going to start flattening tires to the next barber that jacks me up. Guess what? You might as well get you a martyr pass. That box Chevy on 24-inch rims. It's just going to be a box Chevy on brake pads. You may ask yourself, why do I look so homely? Well, I've been completely occupied with things. But now it's time to go get cleaned up. About to go holler at my boy Marcus Harvey and get my shoop tightened up. Made it down to the barbershop for my boy Marcus Harvey to get me straight, everybody.
Now let me tell you guys, can y'all see this? Jamil's hair comes in red on his facial hair, except for that one, that's white. But yeah, I'm here at the salon rim. One of my loyal customers, clients, good friend of mine, Mr. Jamille Harley. But all we know is Range Rover rhythm, cornerstone signature. I don't do it for me, I do it for the liquor store. Said we knew what it be, knew what it's about. Trying 80,000 something for we out. And all we know is Range Rover rhythm, cornerstone signature. I don't do it for me, I do it for the liquor store. Said we knew what it be, knew what it's about. Trying 80,000 something for
we
out.
I'm like a totally different person now, don't I? Harassing me with alcohol. This is my trip to the barbershop. I'm the man, Marcus Harvey. Kitchen trying to get a plate. He will find a way of going drill away. Living like 400. So as you can tell, I'm fresh from the barbershop. I'm clean. I'm fresh to death. No more old man winter looking. You know what's ironic is how you don't know how bad you look until you get a haircut. Like, I thought I was just, going through some. I thought I had that look like I'm going through some things. Now I'm on some close to being summertime fine, which in my mind, that's good enough. Glad you watching episode 3. Stay tuned, stay alone, and stay the course, shout it. Holla at your boy.
I would have never thought in a million years that I would be pursuing something so major. Like, I didn't like challenges as a kid. Now, I see that that's the only way you can live a full life is to accept the challenge. Society, life, this whole world is like Goliath. And anybody following their dreams is always going to be David. Matter of fact, you're going to be smaller than David. You're going to be Papa Smurf. Because the odds are stacked up against you. It's not for you to win. But somehow through it all, I feel like I'm winning.
So here's the thing. I'm back from New York. I had a wonderful time there. I wish I could have showed you my first round footage. But the camera, my friend that was there that was supposed to hold the camera for me, he had technical difficulties, so I didn't get the recording. But I advanced to the next round, and that advancement got me some press. The New York Daily newspaper contacted me, and we had a little small phone interview. And then I noticed that I was on the website and the front page of the paper. It was exciting. I've never been in the paper, and to be in the New York Daily newspaper was awesome. And it was the Queens sector of the Daily News, but I was excited about that. I met a whole heap of dope comics, nice guys. It was amazing. Then I even got to perform at Gotham Comedy Club. It wasn't the main stage, it was the lower stage, but it was a packed house. I'm going to give you some footage. I'm not going to give you all. I'm not going to let all the cat out the bag. But I'm going to let you see some of it. I had a great time. It was an electric night for comedy, electrifying night.
Okay. I dated this girl and I knew I was a rebound because during the whole day, all she did was talk about her ex-boyfriend. The whole time, she talked about her ex-boyfriend so much that I started to miss him. I got on Facebook, I was like, Leroy, I'm sorry. But I miss you. I don't care what she did. I got a 3-for-1 Groupon. What's up? It's for horseback riding. We can ride the same horse. At the same damn time. Now I'm gonna tell y'all something about, if you know anybody by the name Leroy in 2013, he probably is or was a pimp. Every Leroy I know has a fresh perm. If you do your research, you'll realize that Al Sharpton's middle name is Leroy. But it's hard to date now because due to that ordeal, I went and bought a cat. I was depressed. Don't call me. He's adorable. His name is Tony the All I word. He's a gangster. I'll tell you that. But one thing I love to do that it warms my heart is to chase him around the house with the vacuum on high. Like, you see his little heart jumping out of his chest. His pupils dilate real big and black. I say, that's how I feel when I'm driving around with no car insurance, Tony. Do some push-ups, pay some rent. And then I found out that catnip is like crack for cats. Shouldn't have showed me that. I put some catnip on his face, he looked at me, he's like, hey, brother, you got $5 on that motor? He washed them windows for you.
Came back and I had a headline show at the Music Room. Like, I closed out their show. That show was a dope show in itself. Comics came, they brought the heat. It was a nice crowd. I think it was a full house. There was still some standing room, but I think all of the seats, if I remember right, was gone. And if not, then it was like two or three that was empty. But it was just another electrifying night.
Different ethnic groups, I love that. Fellas, let me tell you something, this is a PSA. Do not go to jail, 2013 and above. I'm gonna tell you why. I watched this documentary with this guy named Fleece Johnson. I don't know if anybody's seen it. Scared the shit out of me. Google the Booty Warrior. I'm a killer. The Booty Warrior is what you chose to go with. And this is what he said. He says, booty, or wait a minute, man's butt is more important than food and water.
friends that are like, I need my water. I need my nutrients. He's a mutant gay dude. Like, he took it to a whole different level with that one. And then, well, this is what he said, and I'm going to get in character. He said, they won't let us have a woman. We all get horny. What I'm going to do? You're going to sit down and do something constructive with your time, please. Read a book. Play some chess. Learn the law. Listen, I'm a black man in America. I can go to jail for any damn thing. And the last thing I want to worry about is being chased by this booty bandit. I want to read some more, please. I want to further my education. And this is what he's saying. This is how he get the new guys to come in. He says, I walks up to him and I tell him, look, I like you and I want you. We can do this the easy way or the hard way. Choice is yours. Like this Jeopardy. Like, give me 200 the hard way, Alex. No! I swear, man, that scared me so straight that I didn't cuss for the next 90 days. I was driving, I see a green light, I would stop. He got to the point, man, I saw a police officer at a four-way stop, I just parked my car. I'm walking to work, officer. I got student loans, y'all probably after me. And I got a cousin that he watched it too, I hip him to it, but in his mind, he's an ultra thug. And so he ain't scared of nothing, he ain't never scared. But he just got a letter in the mail talking about he's going to jail for his DUI joints. Like, he's gonna do like 30 days. He's like, oh, that ain't nothing. That ain't nothing. I do that on a headstand, son. That ain't nothing. He's from New York. That ain't nothing, B. And so I called him. Phone rang. He's like, hello. I said, ah, young man. Word on the street, you coming to see me. I like you. And I want you. Don't you know that brother started crying? He started praying to Allah, Jesus, Moses. I think I heard him say in front of Hakeem Olajuwon when I was like, he played for the Rockets.
This weekend, I get a call from the Punchline Comedy Club to host the weekend for SteveO from the movie and the series on MTV, Jackass. I was like, sure, I'll do that. It was we had fun. Steve-O's a really cool guy. Really, it's really refreshing running into people that have a certain level of fame that haven't let it go to their head. Like, they still humble, regular people. I know people. Well, I met people that are like top, maybe B-list celebrities, and they feel like in their mind that they're like A-plus celebrities. I'm like, brother, you haven't had nothing since 1997. Why are you so egotistical? But anyway, Steve-O was mad cool. Shout out to him. The Dan Weeks was the feature. Shout out to him. Shout out to the Punchline for having me. Had a really good time. And most of all, shout out to the people that came out to the shows and was tweeting me and Facebooking me, Instagramming, talking about how much they had a good time. And I'm not the ego type of person, but it feels good to have people recognize the growth. It's people talking about, you were funny, I wish you'd have did more time, blah, blah. Well, that's coming. I'll get more time. It was just a whole spot. But I want to thank y'all for coming out. It was a good weekend overall.
Ladies, do something in 2013. What I need for y'all to do for us fellas is to stop accessorizing hair with more hair. Uh-oh. We lost a few fans on board. I was in the mall last weekend, and I saw this woman with eyelashes the size of eagle wings. Eagle wings, buddy. And she was one of my beautiful black sisters. And I don't know if y'all have ever seen us upset, but we get intense. She got emotionally intense. She took it to another level. She started batting her eyes and rubbing her neck. Don't you know she flew away? She said, this is some bullshit customer service. I need to speak to your manager because I'm not. I'm like, can somebody snipe her? Get your ass down. First Flavor Flav, now this is ridiculous. And it's like when you're in the club, you can't even tell if those girls are asleep, alive, or dead, or nothing, because that laughs me over their face. Then they song come on, they're like, oh, shit. My eyelashes is butterflying.
That's where I'm at. And I thank y'all for staying along. It's been a long month, and the month is over. So let's get ready for June and July and so forth and so on. I've got my fingers crossed. I'm hoping that I get selected for, I think it's like two more festivals that I'm waiting to hear back from. Hope I get selected in those. And just stay tuned, because we coming, y'all.